A conditional statement allows you to run one block of code or another based on a condition. This is an example of a conditional statement in C++. If the condition evaluates as true, then the statement block will be executed. The statement block may be one or more statements enclosed in curly braces. The if statement is the simplest form of a conditional. When the condition is evaluated, it is found to be either true or false. If the condition is true, then the enclosed statement block is executed and flow continues after the conditional. If the condition is false, then the flow continues after the conditional without executing the enclosed statement block. An if statement may also have an else clause, which looks like this in C++. Notice that there is a separate statement block for the else condition. This block of statements is executed if the condition is evaluated as false. The if-else construct works like this. If the condition is true, then the statement block is executed and the flow continues after the conditional. If the condition is false, then the else statement block is executed and flow continues after the conditional. In either case, one and only one of the blocks of statements will be executed. Let's take a look at this in practice. We're going to come down here and create a simple conditional. Take two ints, call them x and y. And then we'll have a simple conditional if x is greater than y, and we'll put condition is true. And when I build and run this, you see it says condition is true because x is indeed greater than y. So in C++, logical values are represented as integers. Zero is false and any non-zero value is true. So if I just say printf value is %d and x is greater than y, I'm evaluating this condition and printing the integer result. And so when I build and run, you see it says the condition is true. It says value is 1. And if I just change this greater than to a less than, you'll see that it says value is 0. This condition is still true because I'm still testing if x is greater than y. But if instead of this, I just say 1, if 1, the condition is always true. And if I say 0, then it says here code will never be executed because the condition is 0. It's always false. If I just put in a number here, it'll be true because any number other than 0 is true. So the way this works is 0 is false and any other number is evaluated as true in C++. So again, if I say x is greater than y and I have an else clause here, I can say puts condition is false. Now when I build and run this, it's true, but if I change this to the less than, now it's false. It says condition is false. Likewise, if I put a 0 here, it says condition is false. And if I put a 1 here, it says condition is true. And now my else says it'll never be executed. And the same thing happens if I put in any non-zero value. So these conditionals, the if and the else, are inherited from C and are exactly the same in both languages. C++ provides a special multi-way conditional using the switch statement. This is a feature from the C language. Let's take a look first at how this works. You'll notice that I've declared four constants. They're integers, and I call them i1, i2, i3, and i4, and they have the values of 1, 2, 3, and 4, respectively. And I've declared another integer called x, which has a value of 3. And now I have this switch statement, which has a number of different options. You notice it has case clauses, case i1, case i2, and wherever x matches one of these constants, that block of code will be executed up until it hits the break statement. And we'll talk more about break later on in this chapter, but break is a branching statement that breaks out of a block. So when it sees break, it comes down here to the matching curly brace, the one that matches the one at the top. So there's all of this as a block, and the break will break out of the block and continue execution after. And then you notice there's also a default. If X doesn't match any of the constants, then default is executed. And all of these have to have a break. Otherwise, the execution will fall through to the next one and it'll execute both of them. And so let's go ahead and run this, build and run. You notice that it says 3. And so that's because X is 3 and it matches I3, which is declared up here on line 8. And so that says puts 3, the string, T-H-R-E-E, and then break. And if I take this break out, it'll print both 3 and 4, watch, because it falls through. And so it's good to understand that. Occasionally you might use it, but for the most part, when you see a switch statement, you'll see breaks after each of the cases. Switch can be very handy in cases where you need to select a condition from a list of possibilities. The case clause requires a constant, so you'll need to take special care to use the proper type for this purpose. The multi-way switch control is inherited from C, although there's different restrictions on the case clause in C.